prayer, the mountain of solution. She has not even started praying. Just stepping into this place, the power of the Lord struck her. And a circle that I've seen over a period of time was released. That will tell you that the power of the Lord is present in this place.
Amen.
And this morning, that same power is here.
Amen.
Let me hear that amen.
Amen.
Let me hear that amen.
Amen.
I say that same power is present here this morning.
Amen.
And whatever is your challenge, whatever is your need, whatever is the problem, whatever is the nightmare, whatever is the turbulent time you are passing through, I want to assure you on this mountain, the mountain of power, the mountain of prayers, this morning, every solution will be released to that problem in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's a prayer program. As usual, I'm not going to talk for much. I'm not going to talk for a long time. You see the scriptures. I speak for a period of time, then we launch into the depth of prayers. Because this, I see the heavens opening upon us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This morning, I'll be speaking to us of the topic, the day of God's power. I say, the day of God's power.
Amen.
And this morning is the day of God's power.
Amen.
I told us we are going to see raw power.
Amen.
And this morning we are going to see raw power in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There is nothing that God cannot do on the day of God's power. And there's no impossibility of the day of God's power. There is no mountain that cannot come down and that will not come down on the day of God's power. The day of God's power is the day you see the glory of the Lord. The day of God's power is the day you experience God. Is the day you see God in action. And today is the day of God's power. I said today is the day of God's power.
Amen.
Today is the day of God's power.
Amen.
And on the day of God's power, every impossibility becomes possible in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's see the book of Joshua. Joshua chapter 10. You open your Bible. You have a copy of the Bible there with you. Joshua chapter 10. We read verse 8 and verse 12 to 14. Joshua chapter 10. You read that along with me. Joshua chapter 10, verse 8. And the Lord said unto Joshua. And the Lord is speaking to someone this morning. Amen.
Amen.
I said the Lord is speaking to someone this morning.
Amen.
And the Lord said unto Pastor Prince, put your name here, personalize it. And the Lord said unto Pastor Prince, and the Lord said unto Joshua, fear not, for I have delivered them into thy hands. Let me hear, amen.
Amen.
The Lord has delivered Goliath into your hands.
Amen.
The Lord has delivered the wicked into your hands.
Amen.
I have delivered them into thy hands. There shall not a man of them stand before thee.
Amen.
I expected a better
amen.
To be able to stand before you.
Amen.
This morning, on the day of God's power, no attack of the wicked one will be able to stand before you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This morning, on the day of God's power, no impossibility.
Amen.
No paralysis.
Amen.
No power.
Amen.
No hardship.
Amen.
To be able to stand before us in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
verse 12. Then spake Joshua to the Lord in the day of God's power, in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel, and he said in the sight of Israel, Saul, stand thou still upon Gibeon, and thou know in the valley of Ajalon. That's the day of God's power. And this morning is not a morning of just sitting down there and say, who will deliver me? It's not a day of just sitting down there and you are overwhelmed. It's not a day of just sitting down there and you feel there's no hope for you. No. On the day of God's power, there is hope.
Amen.
So this morning is a morning of speaking. It's a morning of taking authority. It's a morning of speaking like Joshua of old. Because this morning you are going to speak to that mountain.
Amen.
This morning you are going to speak to the light.
Amen.
This morning is a time of speaking. It's a time of speaking to the barrenness in your life. The wound that they told you that wound is dead. I speak from this pulpit as a servant of God. Your wound is not dead in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. I said that your wound is not dead in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This morning is not your morning. Though I will experience God's power, I'm not going to sit down with the spirit in it. I'm not going to accept what your body is telling them. But I thought I would speak like Joshua and say, no mountain, come down this morning. And say, no sickness that has been tormenting my life, today is the day of God's power. I command you to vanish out of my life.
Amen.
When you speak like that, like Joshua, you experience God's power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So, stand and see upon Gideon, and thou know in the valley of Adam. Verse 13, and the sun stood still, and the sun stood still, and the moon stayed, until the people have avenged themselves upon their enemies. It's not this sitting in the book of Jesha. So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven, and hasting not to go down about the whole day. And there was no day wonderful. And there was no day like that before. And there was no day like that before it or after it, that the Lord hearkened unto the voice of a man. For the Lord called for Israel. That's the day of God's power. We saw the demonstration of the power of the Lord. On the day of God's power, impossibility becomes possible.
Amen.
You see, when you come to this place, for this prayer program, the hour of solution, you don't believe in possibilities. There is no impossibility before our God. Yes. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes.
There is no possibility before our God.
Yes.
I remember that woman. 10 years of marriage. 10 years of people mocking her. 10 years of people gossiping about her. 10 years of hopelessness. Until prayer was made and the power of God came upon her. And the yoke of impossibility was destroyed. And before you know it, the person that they said will not conceive, the person that they said she cannot conceive, the power of the Lord touched her. She conceived. And God gave her a special blessing. And she delivered twins. Special twins. A boy and a girl. Let's clap for the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I remember when her husband called us and said, my wife has delivered twins. A boy and a girl. Where I was in the camp then. I was happy. Because I saw the manifestation of the power of the Lord. I'm this morning, every one of us that has passed on this prayer program, the Lord will cause you to experience His power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
On the day of God's power, impossibility becomes possible. What God cannot do does not exist. You've heard it over and over. What God cannot do does not exist and can never exist. It doesn't matter what you are passing through now. What matters is today is the day of God's power. And this morning, every problem that is round about your life, like a wall, like a mountain, this morning the Lord will roll it away in the name of Jesus. On the day of God's power, mountains of life challenges are rolled away. On the day of God's power, boastful and bragging Goliath is subdued and defeated. Are there people that have bragged over your life? And they told you, as long as I'm alive, you cannot make a headway. They are like Goliaths of old. Goliaths fell, they will fall this morning.
Amen.
I said, Goliaths fell, they will fall this morning.
Amen.
I might say, some time ago, somebody called me and said, Pastor, I am in trouble. I have a challenge with somebody. It wasn't my fault. And she told me, he said, you will see. I thought, when the enemy say, you will see, they go back to back that words up with their back powers. When she said that thing to that person, the person took it lightly. But over a period of time, the person saw things happening in his life. Happening in his life, negative things. Things he cannot explain. Things he cannot explain. Until that day came, he was privileged to meet with us for counseling. And he narrated what happened. And as a minister of the Lord, I know that there is power in the spoken word. And I know that person did not just say that you will see. She went to do certain things to bewitch that brother. And to the glory of the Lord, who exercised authority over the bragging and the boastful Goliath, the yoke was broken. The seed over the life of that man was lifted up.
Amen.
And before you know it, all the clouds of darkness upon his life was rolled away. And whatsoever the Goliath of today have said against your life, they say you will not lift up your head. They say that prayer will not succeed. I want to tell you this morning, the brothers of Goliath will be defeated like your senior brother in Jesus' name.
Amen.
When it is time to pray, you challenge that Goliath. You overturn the words of Goliath. And this morning, the power of the Lord will be manifested in the name of Jesus. What impossibilities are made possible on the day of God's power? On the day of God's power, there is deliverance from the oppressed and the afflicted. On the day of God's power, everything and anything is possible. On the day of God's power, sicknesses that have overwhelmed your life is uprooted. On the day of God's power, doors that have been closed against your womb, against your business is open. And this morning, get ready. Those of us that your womb have been locked up, the enemy locked you up somewhere, and went away with the key. Like somebody bragged sometime and told one of our sisters, he said, I have locked you up. That's your business you see there, I have locked it up. And I've thrown away the key. And when the sister told us, I said, don't worry. That's the all-knowing God who sees where every key in no room is being kept. That God will locate that key and will release you. And prayers was made. Before you know it, that sister was released. Her life that had been locked up was opened. And things began to happen in her life. This morning, you'll be released in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said this morning, you'll be released in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This morning, you'll be released in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The voice of God that is speaking this morning will release you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Remember, all the impossibilities are made possible on the day of God's power. And this morning, you speak to that your mountain. You speak to that your talent. You speak to that sickness. You you speak to Goliath. You speak to the closed doors. When we begin to pray now, I'm telling us there is nothing that God will not do for you this morning.
Amen.
I don't see problem. What I see is the power of the Lord. I see somebody that is there. The enemy has locked you up somewhere. But this morning, on this day of God's power, the Lord is releasing you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You're coming out of that house of captivity in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's a time to possess your possession. It's a time to enter into the charism of the Philistines and release yourself. Rise up as you go to the Lord in prayer this morning. It's the day of God's power. It's the day of God's power. It's the day of taking authority. You have to pray like never before this morning. The day of God's power. The day of God's power. Open your mouth and begin to take authority.
Authority. The day of God's power. The power of the Lord is here. 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 The power of the Lord. That man knows how to pray. That man knows how to pray.
name for prayer.
Amen.
Look up here. Look up here. Everything is possible on the day of God's power. Everything is possible to him that can pray. That's why anywhere I go, anywhere I have opportunity to minister, anywhere I'm invited, I talk about the power of the Lord. I talk about what prayer can do. I talk about the solution that is in prayer. And over the years, I've seen God move. I've seen the power of the Lord. I've seen God does wonders. I remember many years ago, you see, there is nothing that God cannot do on the day of God's power. There is no impossibility before God. I remember many years ago, he told his sister. The medical people told her, they said, your pelvis is too small. And therefore, you cannot give birth to a child normally by yourself. Every child you want to give, you have to come for CS. And when we heard that, medical people are doing wonderful job. But medical science doesn't have the final say. Let me hear an amen.
Amen!
Let me hear a powerful
amen.
The Bible says that they that do know their God. When you know this God, you are confident. When you know this God, you are happy. When you know this God, you have a calm and peaceful disposition. When you know this God, what this God can do, it means that when there are fears all around, within you that is calm. We are going to pray. And pray. And we are praying. We are praying. The first medical report showed the state of that woman. The pelvic naturally was too small. But God can create carry. And we began to pray. We began to pray. After a period of prayer, I told her to go for another medical checkup, to go another ministry. Respect this God. Fear this God. There is nothing he cannot do. Overnight, without the help of any medical science, the president that said is too small. The divine God, the powerful God, the one that has the final say, I've done a miracle in the body of that sister, in the body of that woman. The children she had was a normal delivery.
Amen!
That's what happened on the day of God's power. When the doctor saw the result, he was dazzled. He was dazzled. But our God can do all this.
Amen!
Our God can do all this.
Amen!
I don't know your situation. Maybe you have an impossible situation. Maybe somebody has told you that nothing is not possible. I want to tell you this morning is possible.
Amen.
I say this morning is possible.
Amen.
Maybe somebody has told you and said you can never do well in life. I speak to you this morning as a servant of the Lord. You will do well in life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Maybe somebody has told you and said, look at you for 15 years now. You cannot conceive. You have not conceived. There's no room for you. Who told you that there's no room for you? I announce to you. I bring a divine message to you this morning. That is so for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said that is so for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'm going to arise. I want to begin to speak to your situation. Don't you speak to the son? Don't you speak to the brother? At the battle of Adam, he spoke. Your child is troubling you. Your
as a lady that is here, they say something is wrong with your womb. They say you cannot conceive. Speak into that womb, yes. There is life in my womb. There is life in my womb. I am not married. This womb will carry babies, yes. It's time to speak. It's time to speak. There is power in this paper, yes. Your transport will take the pass. Yes, I see that person. They kept you somewhere. They kept you somewhere. The enemy kept you somewhere. Rise up. Rise up. Rise up. Don't give up for defeat. You speak.